Hello everyone, I'm Eva. I created this channel to inspire you to move, get healthy and fit. Today, I have for you 10 exercises that will stabilize your core to avoid lower back pain. So if you're ready, you don't need any equipment. Let's get started. Start rolling your head. Slowly. And switch sides. One more. And now the shoulders. First to the back. Tap the shoulders. And a bit bigger. And to the front. And a bit bigger to the front. Okay, now shoulders up and down. And down. One more time. Maximal up. And down. Relax. One more time. And relax. Let's go to our hips. We'll move them to the side, to the front, to the side, and to the back. Side, front, side, and back. That's already relaxing for your lower back. Everything that includes hips movement. Go in your own pace and go a bit quicker. And switch sides. Start from going from the side to the front. And now you can go a bit quicker. In your own pace. Let's go a bit lower and start with the cat-cow position in standing. Round your spine and up. Hello everyone. It won't be really difficult in a way that you need weight. It might be helpful if you're struggling with the lower back pain. But if it's really bad, first you have to relax and just put your legs up. After it's a bit better, you can start moving a bit. One more time. Stay down and let's move our arms. Up and switch sides. Up. Look up. Move in your own pace. You don't have to go as quick as me or as slow as me. Let's do two more on each side. One more. And go. Slowly roll yourself up. And move your feet more to the sides. Go from side to side. Just move a bit. The toes up. Hold for a while. How are you doing today? No lower back pain, hopefully. You can still do the workout to prevent it. do two more on each side. One more. And come back slowly. Standing position. Breathe in. One more time. You can drink a sip of water before you start. We have a short moment to start. And the first exercise that we'll do is on your all fours position, in your all fours position. We'll be starting by extending our right arm, left leg, and then going together, connecting the elbow, exercise, right arm to the front, left leg, and then go, connect together. Do this exercise slowly. Focus really on breathing your abs and straighten your spine. And make it round as possible. And let's go a few times like this. You can even hold the position for a while. Up and then down. This one is helping almost instantly. You have lower back pain. Great exercise too. Last one, straighten and go down to your child's pose before you start with the other side. Very short break. Let's prepare slowly. Now your left arm will be going to the front and right leg to the back. Let's prepare. Let's start. Left arm, right leg, and together. Try to keep your hips relatively straight. Elongate your spine and come back. Elongate. And make it nice and round. Don't move just your legs, sometimes I see that. Move also your spine. And together. Right? Try to keep your head in one line in your back. Don't hang it or do too much up. And the last one, elongate and go quickly to your child's pose position. Relax shortly before the next exercise. That will be our glute bridge. You can prepare slowly and lay face up on your mat or carpet. Bend your knees. Your arms are next to your body. Then you go up and down. With your hips. Keep your feet relatively close to your glutes. Don't go too high. Squeeze your glutes. And go down. Do this exercise slowly. Massage your spine. Go up. And Relax strongly. And hug your knees. Squat your chest. And massage your back from side to side. This is great relaxing exercise. You can do it always. And the next one will be glute bridge just on one side. Right. So first put your left foot on your right thigh. And we will be doing the same bridge movement. Let's start straight away. But with the left leg up. Of course, you can hold it up all the time if you want to. Like this, I find it a bit more comfortable to focus using just the right side, go up and down. And again, try to keep your hips straight and go slowly up and down. Try to roll your spine up and then down. And again, up. And slowly down. One last time. Knees at the top. And hug your knees again before we do the same on the other side. Hug your knees. Make some circles with your legs. And let's prepare to the other side. Put your right foot on your left thigh. And we'll be doing exactly the same. On the left, so let's roll slowly and go down. And again, adjust your foot. Go up. Ease your glutes and hold up. Your hips don't have to go that high. Focus on squeezing the glutes. Keeping one line. Your leg. If you don't go too high, might be that your back will take too much pressure again. Not your glutes. Relax again, hug your knees, squat your chest, and go to the side or roll like a ball, your seated position, and then turn around to your all fours position again. We will be doing fire hydrant to kick back, but in the nice rolling movement, starting from the right leg to the side and up. Go to the side, circle around, and go down. Up, around. Hold your abs tight. Try to keep your head in one line with your spine. Do it a few more times to the sides, up and around. Then go down and repeat. Last time down and now thighs fold. Go as low as possible. Relax a bit before we start on the side. Prepare slowly, come back up all fours position and switch position. This is better. What is this all about? And start with your left leg to the side, up and around, do your kickback position and back down. Up, around, and again to the side. Squeeze your abs. Try not to arch your back like this, and always hold it nice and tight at the tabletop. And head one line. Up, around. Let's do one more. Down and relax to high pose. Come back up slowly. We'll target our abdominal. Now let's lay down again, face up, and let's start with the toe caps. Put your arms next to your body. Your legs go to tabletop position, 90 degrees angle, and you go down the pose. Press the mat. Try to keep the 90 degrees angle always, really important. And your back in neutral position. We are targeting the deep muscles, transversus abdominis, really important. Your core stable. So let's do it a few more times. Relax, hug your knees, again, massage your spine, the next one is bicycle crunch, so let's come back to tabletop position with your legs, put your hands behind your back, hide your head, and we will be going with our elbow towards the knee, turning upper body towards the knee, you can also do this exercise a bit quicker if you want to, or if it's too difficult for you, put your feet on the ground and do the oblique crunches just. It's also a great way to start it moving. Let's go. Remember to breathe. Okay? And out. Straighten your legs and arms. We have one more exercise. Now, the straight abdominal muscle, rectus abdominis. Again, the same position, but now we are going up and down. So, reverse crunch. That's the easier version. Bended knees. Let's start. If you want it a bit more challenging, straighten your legs and continue like that. And extend as low as you can. If it's just here at the beginning, that's great. Just do whatever you can. Up. And lower. Up. And lower. Also bend your knees, it is better, it's easier. You feel your abs burning. Not the lower back. If you feel your lower back, please bend your knees. That's much easier. One last. Lower, lower, lower. Really nice. And let's cool down. Go to the back. Raise your arms. Raise your legs. Head forward. Hug your knees. I'll show you a few relaxing exercises that you can do whenever you feel the lower back pain. Massage your spine. Few circles, one direction. Circles another. Feels great. Relax your spine. And again, straighten your legs. Let's turn around. And go up slowly, your child's pose. Put your head on the mat. If you can do it, put something under pillows, put some pillows under your forehead. Maybe you can go that low because of your feet or hips restriction. Just do whatever feels right for you and relax this position. Go up. Of course, if you have more time, you can keep this position, hold this position for a bit longer. Let's go now to another great exercise. Put your right foot to the front. Go down with your hips. You feel your hip flexors at the sound of your thigh stretching. Those muscles are often quite potent. So it's a great way to stretch them. And you can have the lower back pain because they are shortened. They are influencing your lower back. This one might help to relax a bit. If you want to, you can put your hands on the mat, lower. But you don't have to. You are down, put your knee up, move your hips to the front and to the back a bit, a little bit more stretch. And lower your knee down, two down, come back up, and then switch sides. Let's go with another. Leg, in my case it is the left one to the front, and lower your hips as low as you can. Tilt your pelvis to the front, if not you will feel it in your back again. Don't touch your back, tilt your pelvis, though it means that you're not going that low. Are quite low and quite flexible. You can try your hands on the mat. It's important that your back's straight. Some of you might even go elbows. And put your knee up. Take this position. And go with your hips to front, back. Down. If you were down, come back up slowly and come back. Your child's pose at the end. Slowly, slowly, roll yourself back up. Breathe in and out. One more. Thank you very much for working out. I hope it helps.